Sorry, guys, I was on mute for some reason. But welcome to the show. I'm a data host by Nathaniel Evans. The title of the show today is The Art of Baby Steps Just Got Bigger. And it just came to me, you know, because I did a show in the past called The Art of Baby Steps. But this one, I just actually wanted to do an extension on it to show that our baby steps do take us into new plateaus, into new playing fields, into new rooms, into new realities of life, as we basically started certain the little intricacies of who we are, those small manifestations actually start getting bigger and bigger in our life. Most of the things that's out here that's created actually started from a pebble. Businesses, you know, talents, you know, inspiration, leadership, all started from one speck of a thought and actually became this grandiose concept. So I want us to see, you know, what does that look like for us as a people and on a visual, on an individual and as on a collective level. I was supposed to have a guest today, but my guest apparently did not show up. Maybe it was a misunderstanding. I do not know, but it doesn't matter. What matters is that we continue to move forward in our path, right? And that we don't allow things to actually come and remove us in no type of form or fashion, right? I'm learning new things about myself every day. And this is only due to applications of doing certain things. You know, going back to school, you know, reading more, writing my first book, getting it published. These are all things of the art of baby steps. When I was actually in a space of basic confusion, a space of unawareness, and a space of unchange. So today, you know, I look and see what my steps was like in the past, right? And some of the steps that I took in the past, I was in love with them, right? And then some of the steps, I was like, wow, I don't believe I did that. I'm really confused that I would put my life in such a precarious situation. But then I look back and say, you know, today is today and yesterday was yesterday, all right? So as we move into a new space and time, you know, as the clock rolls forward, also does our lives, right? We're not standalone products. You know, we're not statues and things of that nature. Excuse me, guys. We're not statues and things of that nature, right? And this actually goes to show that whatever's going on, we can keep it going on. It can be negative or it could be positive. What we got, whatever we got going on, we can ensure ourselves to continue in that path. And wow, look at that. The power to be who we are is the power to be who we are. The changes that we seek in life are the changes that actually resonate within us, right? Mind, body, and soul, they speak about, right? As we tapping into the spiritual cortexes, as we getting into the mental membranes, right? We actually start reliving and coming into a purpose. And are we living for ourselves? Are we living for the world? You know, are we living for our children? Are we living for the accolades of society? You know, what is the point of actually even stepping out your house and taking those small intricate steps that's actually going to move you to the next level? What be the point of actually striving to be a teacher, a motivational speaker, a consultant, a business owner, a leader, you know, an advocate, a religious person? You know, what would be the point, you know, of building bridges and houses, of accumulating money and things of that nature, right? The art of baby steps is actually understanding a strategic plan and then in turn implementing that strategic plan. I listened to a powerful podcast the other day with Glenn Martin, and Glenn Martin was talking about the art of baby steps. Him, you know, living a life of crime, going into prison, enrolling in college, you know, studying the dictionary and studying different philosophies, you know, mastering himself on a, another level and taking himself to a new plateau. And one of the gifts that he actually gave in that podcast segment was fake it till you make it, right? See yourself in real time. See yourself in the rooms that you want to be in. Go to the places that you believe your energy should be, whether it's warranted or not by others, it doesn't matter. It's you taking yourself to these new spaces and you being that primary for your life, right? We're learning new things, we're learning new gifts, right? And we're actually opening ourselves up to doing different things, right? And I'm looking to see why my other live from Facebook didn't start up, but we're gonna look at it right now, right? And we're gonna put, you know, perspective. Yeah, there you go. So I'm back up and rolling on Facebook. I will be up there. All right. So let me knock the volume out real quick. Matter of fact, I'm going to just do it from Facebook. Okay. All right. All right, so I'm back, guys, right? And I don't know why it's a delay. This is weird. This is some type of delay here. All right, so the art of baby steps just got bigger. And this is important to understand that we have the power to recreate these steps. There's a delay. I'm sorry. So I'm going to go back to where I was at. You can hear me, guys? All right. I don't know what happened and why this thing is being so delayed. And I really can't hear myself in real time. So let me come out of this one because it's not allowing me to be in the moment. Is that better? Hello? Okay. Yeah, so as I was saying earlier, and I'm sorry for the delay, sorry for the misunderstanding, the art of baby steps is us in real time, in real form, according to our real truth. And how do we get to that space? How do we get to a space of real time, a real form, and moving in our space of truth? And it's actually understanding certain key elements about who we are, right? What actually makes us as individuals? What are those crafting products that we use to identify ourselves and to make meaning for ourselves in this mysterious life that we all have? Now, some of us profess to know life more than others. Some of us profess to be superior in things that we do. But where does superiority come from? And where does inferiority come from? Right? How do we get to a notion of understanding what superiority and inferiority actually is? And actually, how do we tap into any one of those things? Because in order to live on any one of those platforms, we had to take the time out to tap into those platforms. It ain't just coming, you know, overnight. It ain't just something that just took place, right? It's something that is a constant reminder of who we are, something that we strive to explore in our lives, regardless of what may be the essence of our change, the essence of our awareness, the essence of our spirituality, even the essence of the physical lives that we choose to live, the people that we choose to love, the people that we don't choose to love, whether we believe in marriage, whether we don't believe in marriage, whether we believe in children, whether we believe animals are more important than children. all of these different manifestations have to derive from the core of who we are. And yes, there are times when there are actually social constructs that actually influence us to move in a certain way and to be a certain individual in this space of time. And if we were to come to a point where, we're going to transition, how many of us can say without a shadow of a doubt that we'd be so happy to transition and that life has been this great, great experience and has opened up a world of opportunities to us that we never perceived? How many of us will actually be able to come to that space? So this is a question to ask ourselves when we are moving and journeying through this time. What do the time of our individual lives look like? Let me take a drink on that. What is the space and time of our individual lives? We had to write a book about our lives, and we had to do a story about our lives. What would that book entail, and what would that story sound like? What would it be? How would it make us, proud of who we are, right? How do we perform accolades, on ourselves? Like we go to spaces and we get awards and we get these different things, but how do we ensure that we are the major accolades for our lives, that we're going to reward ourselves for a job well done? We're going to reward ourselves for coming through dark spaces and coming into a new light. We're going to reward ourselves for actually going to college and finishing the things that we set out to do. We're going to reward ourselves for being more in tune with the processes of life instead of waiting for some outside entity to actually give us that understanding. How many of us would actually be able to say without a shadow of a doubt that this life that we have is a value system? And it's so valued that we want to do it over and over and over again. How many of us, as we're going through the arts of baby steps, what are those steps and where do those steps land us at? Are we in a space of, a smooth transition? Are we in a space of where, things are kind of rocky and things are not the way you want them to be? Are we walking on solid ground? Are we walking in the dirt? Are we walking in the sand, right? What does that look like? What are those small, intricate steps I see look like for you? And what is the picture of those steps? Learning this, and just learning one thing about yourself, that actually clarifies your steps, is the essence of what you need to really grab, the bull by the horns, which is you, right? And navigate you to spaces of comfortability, or spaces of awareness, or spaces of change. What are those spaces of awareness? What are those spaces of change? We're constantly in this basically uphill battle to try to find a presence, right? That's going to allow us to be magnificent in life. Just got bigger. What is just got bigger? Right? Just got bigger is when we actually accomplish a task, a goal. And we actually come into a higher understanding or insight for our lives and not being distracted by all these outside entities that actually move sometimes in sync with who we are and what we want to be in life, right? And just so much that we can find to do in the world, but in just one of us in the one time period. And how do we bring ourselves into a one time period where we can elevate and we can ensure that we remain the essence of change for our own individual lives? Right? There are a lot of distractions and different things that come around us as we're striving to do the things that we need to do, that now we have to understand, like, how do we create a space for ourselves in spaces that sometimes are not in conjunction to who we are, right? You want to go into a room and you want to say everybody's going to love you, but it's not true. You know, you want to do a speech and you want to say everybody love my speech, and it's really not true, right? You may have a majority, which is actually the rule of thumb is to have the majority, but we are not in control of external forces, external spaces. We're not in control of the minds and the hearts and spirits of other people, even though we profess to be, you know, this grandiose being, and we profess to have this, you know, unquenchable knowledge and wisdom. We know when we're by ourselves that we may doubt ourselves, we may question certain things that we're doing. And this is coming from a wise man, you know, wise men who actually take the time out to reanalyze their purpose, you know, to put themselves on a shelf, you know what I'm saying, and write out their story, you know what I'm saying, and say, well, this is what my story was, this is what my story, I want my story to be, right? And this is how I want to change the story that I have created for myself. Well, how do I do that? You know, how do I write this story? Where I start at? Do I ask myself questions? Do I ask other people questions? Do I read books? You know, do I study the Bible, the Quran? You know, do I watch news, right? What's some of the things that's going to allow me to write this story? This story is going to be magnificent for me, right? What does that lesson plan look like? And today, you know, we're learning, you know, as we're going through life challenges and life changes, that everything is not simple, that we're not always going to be, you know, aware of all the things that we need to do and how we need to do it. We get into a space and time where we're striving, you know, to get our footing. We're striving to move outside of normalcies that have not allowed us to grow, that have not allowed us to increase. We move ourselves out of cycles that have been very detrimental to us as people, and find ourselves in a space of harmoniously, right? We find ourselves in a space, you know, of contentment, of love, you know, of hope and faith, because this is and will always be our fundamental building blocks to get to know exactly who we are and actually what we are. And I just want to take a moment, you know, just to contemplate some of the things that has been addressed on this platform today. The purpose of the art of baby steps, the purpose of these steps actually getting bigger and not staying, you know, in this whirlwind, this cycle, not allowing us to basically spring forth and burst through certain things. Like, how do we burst through? How do we change, you know what I'm saying, the trajectory of who we are? If we come to a point and say, you know what, I don't like who I am. I don't like my life. You know, I don't like the way it has been moving. I don't like the people that's in my life. You know, I'm not growing in this aspect. I'm not growing in that aspect. I'm growing in this aspect. What more can I do to increase that growth? What does this change in real time for you look like? Are you able to wait until tomorrow to actually ask yourself questions about your life? Are you able to wait until next week, maybe next month? You know, would it take you a whole year, you know, to actually come to a greater, you know what I'm saying, acceptance of who you are, a greater awareness of who you are? And every time as individuals we have come to the space of knowing life has tricked us. So, yo, you don't know me, man. You know, I'm like a best friend. I've been walking with you for 50 years and you don't even know my middle name, right? It's moving in the course of time, in the real moments of time, to learn that you have the ability and the perspective to shift, to pivot, right? And to move in a space of true, unadulterated awareness. You're dealing with this here, right here. You're dealing with this. We open up the third eye. You're going into a new space. You're going into a new time. And we're learning that there's a great value system that's out there just waiting for us to tap in. Or may I say that's in there, that's waiting for us to tap in so we can actually manifest it into the world. And not for the accolades, right? Not to be known according to this or be known according to that, but just to move according to your true space. And just to know that you have the value system to love yourself on a higher plateau. Are we able to do this? Are we able to learn the things we need to learn about ourselves, to analyze those steps that we have been taking in life, and ask ourselves, you know, if I'm following the GPS and the GPS says turn right or turn left, you know, sometimes I might look at the GPS just to confirm, is that the way I have to go? Because maybe I have my own compass. Right? So I don't want to just believe in the GPS 100% because I have my own compass. I have my own awareness. I have my own identity. And this allows me to be connected to me. This allows me to trust in my instincts, you know, trust in the path that I'm going through, you know, analyze my true purpose of doing something, of going somewhere, of reliving the moment of life. It's being a part of that essence that gathers me to a whole new plateau and increases me into a space of self-worth. How do I get into a space of self-worth? How do I move out of spaces that are not providing me the worth of who I am? And how do I get out of my spaces of confusion, spaces that there is no key awareness of basically what I'm doing? I'm just basically like going through the motions, right? Harming myself with this, harming myself with that, you know, belittling myself with belittling thoughts, you know, being in disbelief about what my life really is and how I can actually channel this new essence, and learning from, you know, our past experiences, and then shifting outside that cortex. Because, you know, our past experiences at time becomes our trap. It becomes something that we're not able to easily escape, because for some unknown reason, right, and maybe this might be a scientific thing, I'm pretty sure it is, that we tend not to forget or forgive ourselves from our past experiences that we endured, and we look to try to bring a clarity to a space that has already expired. And we try to compare ourselves to a space that is no longer there for us to evaluate and to actually make changes in, because that space has actually expired. The art of baby steps is moving past that space that you are no longer in. You're no longer in that space. We're no longer in the past, right? We're moving in the present to move into the future. A lot of times we don't even know what the present is, because once 1 second passes past the present, then it's the past. It's like the last statement I said, it was actually in the past. And now I'm back in the present moment. And now you will see some of the things I'm doing in the future moments. If you're not on this podcast with me in real time, you will just come across this podcast one day and say, wow, I see this guy, man. You know, I'm listening to what he's saying. Now, he has some type of semblance of truth. Some things I agree with, some things I don't. But now we're going to a future evaluation, and we're able to analyze it in our futures, right? things that we did not analyze in the past, things that we not analyze in the present moment. And we start understanding that there is actually no quick fix. You know, I'm a data, you know, was basically spawned out of me going through my different changes and me coming to my different awarenesses and me putting those things in perspective and laying them out on the table so I can learn about who I am, what I am, what I want to become, and how I want to be able to identify myself in the world according to this life that I have. Right. And, you know, I might say, why am I alive? Why did I, you know, why did I come here? And what is my purpose? And it's just getting to a space of understanding that we don't know all things that's actually in our lives or actually within our lives or even within the core of who we are. But to be still, to be silent, to tap back in and to have the audacity and the faith that you can find certain key elements about who you are to answer some of your hard keynote questions is the beginning of this change. It's the beginning of this life model and the beginning of a truth that we actually need in order to sustain ourselves in times of one of unawareness, in times of confusion. We have to be able to tap back into that and learn about who we are, because we can forget who we are. We can be so explosive one time and then be so downtrodden the next that it's mystical. It's mystical in a great way. And some of the gifts that we had, we may have taken for granted, and then we have to learn what those gifts are, but then those gifts come in a different form and a different manifestation. And now we're balancing ourselves, right, to clarity. Yes. We're balancing ourselves to a space of clarity, a space of understanding. Right, a space of challenging the normalcies of our lives and moving to a new spectrum that's in our lives. And today, you know, I didn't have a guest. So when I don't have a guest, I actually have a half an hour show. When I have a guest, I do an hour show. So today I'm actually going to, you know, get off in about 2 minutes. And next week, maybe I might have a guest again, you know, and to see, you know, how that one's going to work out. But the art of baby steps is for me to continue to do what I'm doing. Me continue to ask you guys to subscribe, to support me in my endeavors, to listen to my data, to send me content I can listen to from you, collaborate. I come on your show, you come on my show, you know, ask me a question or two. You know, I'm here to answer those things. You know, you want me to help you create something, I'm here to help you create something as well. But the art of baby steps is learning the value of you, being connected to the value of you, and taking the necessary steps that you need to take to get to that value that you perceive, that you know is there. No one has to tell you that there's something there that you have to tap into. There's something that you have to do in order for you to be able to live your life on new terms, according to new values, belief systems, goals, morals, and things of that nature. I ask you to subscribe so I can grow. I ask you to reach out to me so I can subscribe to your channels as well so you can actually grow. And I ask you to look at your art of baby steps and to ask yourself this one keynote question. How can those baby steps get bigger? What do I need to do to increase the art of my baby steps? And how do I tap in to the essence of who I am and the value of who I am according to the steps I take today? How do I do it? Good day, guys. Great talking to you.